Shares of CannTrust really taking a wallop today, down 23% at the close to $5 even, running afoul of Health Canada. The big cannabis producer says it was deemed non-compliant with certain regulations, that a result of some production in unlicensed spaces. Now, all told, more than 12,000 kilograms of inventory has been placed on hold, and CannTrust is warning about potential product shortages. Joining us now to discuss the story, Eric Foster. He is a partner at Dentons Canada. Good to see you, Eric.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
So here we go. We have another issue with a big marijuana player in the States, raises all kinds of questions about compliance, about oversight, and investors. Clearly, investors didn't like the sound of this. What does this do to the credibility of the name?
You know, it hurts the industry overall, but again, this is a problem that I think a lot of companies are dealing with. CannTrust is the one in the news today, but at the end of the day, you've got to step back and look at the industry, right? This is an industry that has experienced such rapid growth, and also the businesses are changing, right? All these businesses used to be primarily medical, and now they're focused on real consumer products. And when you're dealing with that sort of growth, you're going to have growing pains. And that's an example of what we're seeing today, I think, where just necessarily that operational excellence and oversight just wasn't where exactly it needed to be, unfortunately.
Now, I understand in this case right here, these unlicensed rooms where the marijuana was being grown from October to about March, they became licensed rooms in April.
Correct.
So how does Health Canada view, clearly they were not in compliance if this is the situation ahead of them, those rooms being licensed, but eventually they were. How does Health Canada play this? I mean, how serious this is in their eyes?
Look, I think it's serious. At the end of the day, this is a very regulated substance, and the government has taken steps to bring this to Canada under that regulatory scheme. So it's really important that it's enforced very closely. And at the end of the day, my guess is these were rooms that eventually they were licensed. But it's really important. It really highlights the importance for these companies to put in place protocols for quality control and things to ensure that when you're dealing with a regulated substance, you are following the rule of the law.
Now, the fact that they were using these unlicensed rooms to grow their marijuana, we've heard a lot about the industry struggling in terms of getting product to market, and being able to grow it, being able to supply the numbers that the market needs. Does this sort of speak to that, a bit of almost a scramble to say, we just can't grow, we don't have enough room to grow what we need to grow?
Sure, yeah, capacity has been in the news every single day for a number of years now, and as soon as it went legal on October 17th, you've read about the shortages, whether you're going to the stores and there's just not supply there, and it's not just in Ontario, it's all over Canada. It has been a struggle for the companies to basically ramp up their production. I think if you look at kind of all of the anticipated capacity, there's going to be more than enough production in Canada in the future, but it's something that has been a struggle for the companies right now to get up to that number where they want to be.
Now, the seriousness of what we're seeing right now, the company came out with a statement today, the CEO, Peter Sato, saying, we've made some mistakes, we're trying to work to make this right with Health Canada. Will there be individuals, potentially, who will be sort of the collateral damage in all this? So yeah, does someone have to take the blame here?
Well, I think to a certain extent you're seeing that in the market today in terms of taking the blame, right? And I thought the statement put out was the right sort of statement to make. At the end of the day, they have an obligation to their stakeholders. They have to take responsibility for this and ensure that the public sentiment is not questioning this, right? At the end of the day, you just want to be open, say a mistake was made, and we've taken steps to rectify it, and here's what we've done, and it's not going to happen again.
I imagine the conversations for the next couple of days will start to center around board oversight once again. Who, as you said in the beginning, these fast-growing industries, they're moving quickly. Mistakes we have seen are being made, but there is a board supposed to be overseeing all this. I mean, how much does the conversation switch to that and the need for greater governance in this space?
Yeah, I think there's been a lot of discussion in time about corporate governance in the sector. From my perspective, I actually think this is more of an operational matter than a board oversight issue. That being said, the one thing that has surprised me more than anything, having worked in this industry for a number of years, is the speed at which the industry has become both sophisticated, but also legitimate. And I think you're seeing better directors, better officers, better managers coming into these companies. And with that, you're right, there will be an expectation for that operational excellence, right? If you see a lot of the boards have historical directors who may have been on the shell companies before they went public. And now you're seeing really successful business people come in and step onto these boards. And you would expect them to demand better performance and make sure mistakes like this don't happen.
Now, obviously, we saw a considerable step back one day, down more than 20%. Investors are used to a certain degree of volatility in these stocks. I mean, any given day, the group might go down 5% or surge 6%. But in terms of CannTrust, there's a real issue here. Like, what do they need to do to start to regain the market's sort of faith.
Well, I think that's exactly right. They have to take steps to regain the faith of the market. And I think that press release this morning was a great example of that. Going in with hands clean. At the end of the day, when you're dealing with a regulated industry, a regulated substance, all we would ever advise our clients to do is go in with, open kimono, go in with clean hands. A mistake was made, admit it, and take steps and show the public the steps that you have taken to ensure that there is that level of operational excellence going forward.
Now, this is an industry we know that since we did legalize last fall has faced a number of sort of challenges. I think the next catalyst some people are looking towards is the edibles and the consumables market. From your point of view, does that change the game all that much once they come online, when they become legal?
Yeah, I think it does. And if you look at even what happened today, it talked about rooms that were growing, but that were eventually licensed, but ultimately at the time the product was being grown, it wasn't licensed there. And I think companies also have to be very mindful about the new regulations with edibles in terms of making sure you're not doing things you're not supposed to be doing until such time as you are allowed to be doing that. And again, I think with edibles too, there's concentrates, people aren't entirely sure how your body is going to react, how your body will metabolize to that. So again, having proper protocols in place to ensure quality control are going to be even more important for these companies going forward.
Is there a feeling among some of these companies that the regulatory environment is just a little too strict? I mean, the CEOs come on and they say, of course, we need to welcome regulation in the sense that this is a product that can't get into the wrong hands. But it seems that there's a lot of hoops to jump through, and particularly when it comes to marketing the product as well.
Yeah, for sure. And I think that's the exact area where there's been kind of the most confusion in terms around marketing and branding. On the same note, the government did move this to a legal industry, and you would expect it to be highly regulated. I don't actually think there's that many people complaining, that many companies complaining, saying the regulatory oversight is too burdensome. I think over time, as this becomes a little bit more accepted by society, then the laws will liberalize over time. But right now, I think they're probably about where they should be.
Fascinating stuff. Thanks for joining us, Eric.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
It's Eric Foster. He is a partner at Dentons Canada.